Hi, welcome to a product tutorial by Robojax. My name is Ahmad Shamshiri, presenting this tutorial from Canada. In this tutorial, we're going to learn how we can use this digital temperature control W3001 from DIY Moore to control AC load. We are going to learn how we can use this as a cooler control, and also we are going to learn how we can use it as a heater control. And then let's get started with this. For this AC version, I have separate videos explaining the DC version of the same 3001. The link for that video is below the video in the description. Now let me explain the module. The module is very simple. It has two push buttons that arrow up and down, and there is an LED that when the output is turned on, it will turn on, and also the value that you see here continuously, it shows the current temperature that is attached to this, or room temperature. Applied some heat here, that's why the temperature has increased. Actual room temperature is now 24 degrees at the moment, so it is slowly decreasing. And on the maximum it can handle is 10 ampere for the AC load. And this will be connected to the AC, which I've already connected it. This goes directly to the wall outlet. And this is the output where I can connect my load, either heater, refrigerator, fan, whatever device you have. And this can be immersed directly inside the liquid or just on air. Now these switches have functions. If I press this, it shows the starting temperature, and if I press this, it shows the stopping temperature. So we have two temperatures, start and stop. And if you want to change the starting temperature or stopping, bring it on the screen and then hold this. As you can see, you can increase or decrease it or change it. And if you hold this, it will go much faster. Let's see what is the maximum. It goes to 120 degrees. And let me hold this and see what is the minimum. So minus 55, that's the minimum. If you wait for a few seconds, it returns back to the room temperature. Now, that was the start. If you want to change the stop, press this, that's the stop. And then you can hold this, and that is where the stop temperature can be adjusted. A few seconds, the screen will return back, and now you can check the start is 11.6 and the stop is 42.1. This is labeled as 110 to 220 volts, and I'm connecting it to 110 volts. It works. And also this one, this has been labeled at 220 volts. Actually, it works also with 120 volts in Canada that I'm testing it now. Version. So we have microcontroller here. This is AC to DC converter. We have two wires here, and this has been labeled. The red is the live wire. This is the neutral wire or ground. So this is a hot or live wire. And these two are, this is the live or hot wire, and this is the neutral. This neutral, the black, is the same. If you pay attention from the top, these two blacks are connected. So when you connect the AC and enters, directly exits back, so this is the neutral. And the live also powers this, but the live goes through the relay and exits this way. And this is the NTC temperature sensor, which is connected at this point. So we can close it simply like that. And if you want to know the exact distance between the center of the holes, they are 72.2 millimeters. and the total distance is 85.9 millimeters. The length of this is 59.6 millimeters, 60 millimeters. The width is 44.3 millimeters. The depth is 30.5 millimeters. To start preparing this for AC, I have to warn you that when working with AC, it's very dangerous. You have to be very careful and take a lot of precautions. And every step, the power must be disconnected before you work. And if you're unsure how to proceed with this, seek help from a professional. Now, in order to turn on and off something, this is my extension cord. This is the plug. This is in Canada and the US. We have this type of plug. Get in a wire, an extension cord, something like this, and this will go to the wall and cut it somewhere here, which I have done. And in US and Canada, we have the plugs are different, so we know which one is live and which one is neutral. The small one in Canada, the small one is the live one. And if I put it here, you will see that this I've already put it. So the small one is the live or hot, and I've labeled this so I don't make mistake. Now I'm going to this one that goes from to the wall, I will solder it at these two plus and minus. So I want to make sure that live is connected to the red and then neutral is connected to the black. So this is for the input, and then I'm going to connect this for my load. At this point, yellow is alive and then black is the neutral. Now this wire has been soldered. I will have the heat shrink here closer so it is covered, and also at this point this piece have been connected to this part. It has been soldered. And I will use heat gun. And the same way in here. Now this is ready. I can plug this in directly to AC. And here I'm going to connect my heater or fan or whatever we want to control with this. Now let's set this to the heater, and we have a start temperature of 50 degrees and a stop temperature of 65 degrees. And how it works is that because this is a heater, we are keeping the heat. Meaning if the temperature goes below 50, it will start and will heat up, and we don't want above 65 or whatever temperature you want, so that's our stop temperature. Now let me set the start for 50. So if I press this, that's the start, and then hold it again and then increase. I'm going to change it to 50. So that is the start temperature. Wait until it blinks and disappears. Now this is for stop when you see it, but if we hold it you can change it. Now I'm changing that to 65. So I've set start 50, stop 65 degrees, and as you can see, because the temperature of the room at the moment is below this 50 degrees of start, the heater, the temperature is the output is on. Now I'm connecting this AC bulb, and this is my heater, cooler, whatever. I'm just connecting it as a load for demonstration purpose. And now this is the plug for this bulb, and as you can see, because the output is on, if I plug it in, the bulb is on. So I'm going to heat this up, and you will see it will stop at 65. So this is my heat gun. Mastercraft from Canadian Tire. So let's apply, and you can see the temperature here. At 65 it stopped, and as you can see the temperature is now way above because it absorbed a lot of heat. The heater is off because it's above the temperature. Now as the temperature decreases at 50 it will start. So I'm holding this with my hand so the temperature can decrease faster. Now very fast. So now again the heater is on, and if this is the heater, then the heat should increase slowly. When it reaches 65, it will just turn off. Now we are using it as a cooler, and start is now 65. And start and stop has changed. When the start is higher than stop, because it's a cooler, the start is now 65. So let me press this. This is a start, and press this as a stop. We have to switch it. When I press this start, let me increase it to 65. So that is a start, 65. And now wait until it disappears. Then press this, that's a stop. So let's set it to 50. And then just give it a few seconds until it blinks out. Now start is 65, stop is 50, and this is how we have set it. It will act as a cooler. Now I'm connecting my external load here, this one. Because the output is off, it is off. And the job of the cooler is to keep the temperature below 60. Below 65 and start the cooling at 50. Because now it is below 50, it is not turning on. So I'm going to use my heat gun now, and here the sensor, I'm just applying some heat. Pay attention, the cooler will turn on when the temperature reaches 65. So the cooler is now turned on because it's heat up. Now the cooling system should bring the temperature down. So if I hold this in my hand, let me speed it up so it can go quickly. Now pay attention, at 50, when the temperature reaches 50, it should stop. 52, so faster it is going now. And at 50 it turned off. This is how you can use it as a cooler or heater. Thank you for watching. This was how to use this W3001, a temperature control either as a heater or cooler. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, post it in the comment section below and make sure to subscribe. I will reply to all my subscribers. Hi, welcome to a product review. Hi, welcome to a product review by Robojax. In this video, we are going to learn Hi, welcome to product review by Robojax. In this video, we are going to learn how we can use the W3002 temperature. In this video, hi.